am so glad to be back here. It's been a little while. Welcome back to fall in Nashville. It's finally not so hot that we can't stand being outside. I hope you guys are enjoying your time here. If you don't live here, we hope you'll come back a lot. See us. Time you take a sip in this smoky atmosphere, you press that bottle to your lips, and I wish I was your beer. In the small hair of your back, your jeans are playing peekaboo. I'd like to see the other half of that butterfly tattoo. Yeah, that gives me an idea. Let's get out of this bar, climb out into the country, find a place to park. I'd like to see you out in the moonlight. I'd like to kiss you way back in the sticks. I'd like to walk you through a field of wildflowers. I'd like to check you for ticks. Ooh, you never know where one might be. Ooh, there's lots of places that are hard to reach.
Brad Paisley, everybody. Don't you just want to jump and raise your cup when you hear him? Well, trust me, it won't stop with him, because in a little bit, the same thing's going to happen when the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band takes the stage. And after that, when Brothers Osborne make paper pieces out of our speakers. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Opry Live. I'm Natalie Stovall. Now, if you tuned in a few weeks ago, you saw a show we put together with previously unaired performances. That turned out to be so much fun, we're doing it again tonight. All the artists you see here on the show, we taped late last year, but didn't have room for them. Until tonight. So the Brad performance you just saw and the one still to come, we taped last fall. And it's just as much fun now as it was then. So let's get back to it. Raise your cup, because here again is Brad Paisley.
How many people are from out of town? I heard Mountaineers. I heard that yelled. Yeah. Where else we got? Who's the farthest away? Did I hear Alaska? Canada. I heard Canada. Canada. Welcome. Welcome. I'm glad they let you guys in. We're all
All about those Canadians. All about you guys. She put him out like the burning end of a midnight cigarette. She broke his heart, and he spent his whole life trying to forget. We watched him drink his pain away a little at a time, but he never could get drunk enough to get her off his mind until the night he put that bottle to his head and pulled the trigger and finally drank away her memory. Life is short, but this time it was bigger than the strength he had to get up off his knees. They found him with his face down in the pillow, with a note that said, I love her till I die. And when we buried him beneath the willow, the angel sang, whiskey lullaby, la 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 la. Welcome back, Kaylee Hammock.
The rumors flew that nobody knew how much she blamed herself. For years and years, she tried to hide the whiskey on her brow. She finally drank her pain away a little at a time, but she never could get drunk enough to get him off her mind until.
Strength she had to get up off her knees. We found her with her face down in the pillow, clinging to his picture for dear life. We laid her next to him beneath the willow while the angel sang. That's the real deal right there.
Opry Live is brought to you by Balsam Hill, beautifully realistic Christmas trees and decor, and by proud partner of the Grand Ole Opry, Humana. It's not just healthcare, it's human care.
Well, hello to all of my live streamers out there. It's Natalie Stovall hanging out backstage here at the Grand Ole Opry in the Cowboy Way dressing room, getting to watch this very special Opry Live with you guys. Y'all, We had so many incredible performances in 2022, and we actually did this a couple of weeks ago together, where we took some of the extra performances that we didn't have time to put into an original Opry show and put them together, because there's just too many great performances that we don't want you guys to miss out on these. So we had to put this show together, and I'm so glad we did. I mean, talk about such a special performance. Whiskey Lullaby, one of the greatest country songs that we have. Brad Paisley bringing out Kaylee Hammock to sing that song with him on the Opry stage, which I think Kaylee's voice is unbelievably perfect for this song. They sounded so good together. And this is one of those songs that has a bit of a legendary story behind the writing of the song. This was written by John Randall and good old Whispering Bill Anderson, one of our Opry members. And John was going through a bit of a rough patch in his life. At the time, he had just gotten a divorce from his then-wife, Lori Morgan, and then he lost his publishing deal, and he lost his record deal, all within the same few days. So he was not having a good time in life. And so John went to a friend and stayed with this friend for a bit, and he kind of just drowned his sorrows. And after a couple of weeks, he kind of cleaned himself up and was like, man, I'm so sorry. I just am having a rough time. And his friend, he actually said, that's all right, John. I've put the bottle to my head and pulled the trigger a few times too. What a line. That's just a line that his friend said to him. So of course, John Randall, being the songwriter that he is, he remembered that. He took that idea to Whisperin' Bill because they had a write set up, and he was explaining about this time in his life, and they wrote Whiskey Lullaby. They wrote a very dark, double suicide kind of song that is not the kind of song that a lot of artists are going to jump to cut. You know, it's harder to get some of those really dark songs cut, but man, jump to 5 years later, Brad Paisley heard this song and he thought, you know what, we're going to make this a duet and it's going to be perfect with Alison Krauss on it. My goodness, country legends right there, and we're going to get to more country legends right now on the Grand Ole Opry. Hey everybody, welcome back to Opry Live. I'm Natalie Stovall. Well, these next guys have churned out over 26 albums in their career. And let me tell you, there's not a clunker among them. They have consistently produced solid country music over and over and over again. And for all you diehard country fans, both old and new, three of them are iconic essential albums. Three. Check out their Circle Be Unbroken, volumes 1-3. They will blow your shoes and socks right off. So lock your doors, scoot up your chair, turn up the volume, and pay attention, because here is the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band.
Well, good evening. How are y'all doing? We're so happy to be back at the Opry. I knew a man, Bojangles, and it danced for you. Thank y'all. Worn out shoes, silver hair and ragged shirt and baggy pants. Do the old soft shoe. Jump so high, jump so high. And then it lightly touched down. Met a man a sail in New Orleans. I was down and out. He looked to me to be the eyes of age. Yes, he spoke right out. He talked of life. He talked of life. Heels and still. Yeah, he said his name, Bojangles, and he danced a bit across the sail. Grabbed his pants and spread his stance for a jump so high. Shook back his clothes all around. Mr. Bojangles, about Bobby Carpenter and Jimmy Fan, y'all? Thanks for those who missed the shows in county fairs. Throughout the South, and he spoke through tears of 15 years, I was dogging him. They traveled about with a dog up and died, up and died. After 20 years, he still grieves. He said, I'd dance now at every chance and honky tonk. Four drinks and tips. Most of the time I spend behind these county bars, 'cause I drink a bit. He shook his head, and as he shook his head, I heard someone ask him, please. Mr. Bojangles, won't you dance? I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you. Thank you all so much. Over to my right, this is my son, Jamie Hanna, y'all. My name's Jeff Hanna, by the way. Nice to be here tonight. All right, kids, here we go.
If you're traveling in the North Country Fair, where the wind hits heavy on the borderline, remember me to one who lives there, for she once was a true love of mine. And if you go when the snowflakes storm, where the wind is freezing, summer ends, please see she has a coat so warm to keep her from the howling winds. Please see for me if her hair hangs long, if it rolls and flows all. Please see for me if her hair hangs long, for that's the way I remember her best. She remembers me at all. Many times I've often prayed in the darkness of my night, in the brightness of my day. If you're traveling in the North Country Fair, where the wind's in heavy on the was a true love of mine.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Let's take a little fishing trip, y'all. Coming up tonight, shining through the trees. The crickets are singing and the lightning bugs are floating on the breeze. Baby, get ready. Anybody ready out there tonight? Yeah. Across the field where the creek turns back by the old stump road. I'm gonna take it to a special place that nobody knows. Baby, get ready.
Ooh. You and me going fishing in the dark. Lying on our backs and count the stars where the cool grass grows. Down by the river in the full moonlight. We'll be falling in love in the middle of the night. Just move and slow.
Good to be with y'all tonight, yeah. Spring is almost over and the summer's coming. The days are getting long. I waited all winter for the time to be right just to take you along. Baby, get ready. It don't matter if we sit forever in the fish don't bite. Jump in the river and from the heat of the night. Baby, get ready. Come on, baby.
Ooh. You and me going fishing in the dark. Move and slow.
fishing in the dark. Thank you all so much.
Opry Live is sponsored in part by Dish Network.
Well, hey there, live streamers, the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, let's go. I love Fishing in the Dark so much. That's one of those songs that I have played so many times in my shows, and I don't really know a band that hasn't played that song. That's one of those songs you can sing it anywhere in the country. It doesn't matter. Everyone in the room cannot wait to sing that chorus with you. Everyone's on their feet. It just brings people together. That's such an amazing song. And I'm so glad that we're getting to watch this set with the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band together, because they're one of those bands that I'm very aware of and I love a lot of their music, but I haven't gotten to see them live a bunch. So it's really fun to see them playing on the Opry and playing Mr. Bojangles. Okay, Mr. Bojangles is a song that I knew was a Nitty Gritty Dirt Band song. I also knew it as a Bob Dylan song, and then come to find out there's been all kinds of people who have recorded this song. But the origin of this song, this is another great legendary songwriting story. So a guy by the name of Jerry Jeff Walker, he wrote this song in 1968 after he shared a cell with a homeless man who called himself Mr. Bojangles. They were put in this cell together overnight. There was a bunch of drunk fellas in the cell together, and everybody was talking, and as you can imagine, everyone was intoxicated, and Mr. Bojangles, who wouldn't give his real name, he just called himself Mr. Bojangles, he kind of was bringing the mood down because he was talking about losing his dog, and it was his best friend, and it was just really sad, and somebody said, hey, you need to lighten the mood a little bit, and so Mr. Bojangles just got up and started tap dancing, just like that, out of nowhere. And this whole scene just stuck in his mind, in Jerry Jeff's mind, and he wanted to write a song about it. So, and one of my favorite quotes is that he said, on a night when the rest of the country was listening to the Beatles, I was writing a 6/8 waltz about an old man and hope. And then this song went on to be recorded by some of the most legendary artists and went on to be a big hit for the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. It was a top 10 hit for them. They still play it to this day every time they play a show. It's just amazing. So those legendary songwriting stories that you get here on the Grand Ole Opry, it's just the best. And we have so much more show to get to. So right now, I'm going to throw it back to myself on TV. Well, hey, everybody. Welcome back to Opry Live. Natalie Stovall here. You know what's crazy about these next guys? Their command of the music they play and any stage they sing from is as if they've been doing it for 40 years. And yet, they only have 3 albums out. 3. Which tells you a couple of things. One, their music is so good that we all love on their albums for years before we demand more. And two, they were just born to do what they do, and that's to make country music straight from their souls. That, my friends, is a country music blessing. Here are Brothers Osborne.
How we feeling out here tonight, everybody? Damn, how? upon yesterday. Dig into your inventory, it's gonna send me to an early grave. You got skeletons in your closet, it's written all over your face. Every little line stacked so high can keep your story straight. I don't know. The song, we don't play it very much. It's a song that we were just recently nominated for a Grammy for, and it's our kind of reimagination of Willie Nelson's On the Road Again. And we took his chorus, and with his blessing, we kind of reimagined it through, you know, the road isn't always an easy place, especially when you start off in a 12-passenger van, and that's where this was inspired from. Smoke and gasoline, born to live a midnight writer's prayer. Same boots, new town, same tunes, new crowd. Trying to get to heaven for the devil even knows we're there. On the road again, like a band of gypsies, we roll down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning. In our way, we go hard, live fast, play guitars for bar tabs. If there's a crowd, the show will never end. So we set it up and we tear it down. 400 miles to the next town. Gotta drive all night just to do it all over again. Road again, like a band of gypsies, we rode down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way, in our way. Beginning on the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we roll down the highway. We're the best of friends,
insisting that the world keep turning onward and onward on the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we rode down the highway, brothers till the end, insisting that the world keep turning onward and onward.
Thank you. Opry Live is sponsored in part by Dish Network.
Well, hey there, live streamers. It's Natalie Stovall hanging out with you guys backstage at the Grand Ole Opry and watching this very special Opry Live. Y'all, we did this a couple weeks ago where we took some of the extra performances from last year that we didn't have time to fit into the original Opry Lives, but we had all these extra performances that are so great that we had to share them with you. Now, we put together a special episode a couple weeks ago. Y'all loved it. I loved it. We had to do it again, and that's what we're doing tonight. Now, Brothers Osborne, one of my favorite country bands out there. I love those guys so much. I love their music. I love their hearts. And they just sang a song called Midnight Rider's Prayer, which is a song that they wrote. This has another one of those, we're talking a lot about songwriting lately, these legendary songwriting stories. They wanted to write a song about life on the road. And as they were writing this song, they just couldn't come up with a better chorus than Willie Nelson's On the Road Again. I mean, who could come up with a better chorus? That is the most perfect chorus for a song about life on the road. But these guys, they had written a song that was a good bit darker than Willie Nelson's carefree version of Life on the Road. But, you know, no matter what they tried, they were like, now we got to put that chorus in this song. But, of course, you can't just do that. And so they had to get Willie's blessing. So they sent the song to Willie. Willie was like, oh, I love this. Of course, do this, guys. And not only that, he sent the song to his good buddy, Chris Christopherson. No big deal. The guys said that they just freaked out about that because they didn't even know that either one of them would know who they are. So I love that little tidbit. But it's so cool because then you can rewind it back to how Willie Nelson wrote On the Road Again originally. He was cast in a movie in 1980 called Honeysuckle Rose. And he was on a plane to head out to start filming this movie. And the executive producer of the film said, hey, can you write a song for the film about life on the road? And Willie was like, well, I know a good bit about that. I can definitely do that. He took out a barf bag and just started writing On the Road Again. And he knew he had a song when he had to turn the bag over to continue writing the song. How is that how a song is born? That's just so amazing to me. So now we have two amazing songs out of that On the Road Again song. And we have a lot more Brothers Osborne to get to, so I'm going to throw it back to myself on TV.
Some people clap on a one and three. Some people clap on a two and four. Some people don't join at all, cause they got no rhythm, and that's alright. Some people, they drink too much, and some people don't drink enough. Some people are just like me. I hope y'all forgive them. I'm like Scotch inside a gold band. I'm like Eastside Towns, hands in. Speaking my mind when I'm better off. It'd be a bit bitter. If you took a drink, you might reconsider. If I was a church, I'd be hanging with the sinners, talking about Hank Williams in heaven. If I was a bar, I'd be a dive, a free jukebox and a double wide, a neon light saying come inside, and I'd be open 24/7. I'm like Scouts inside of gold bands. I'm like Beast out of towns, fam, fam. Speaking my mind when I'm better off biting my tongue. I'm a bad joke at the wrong time. This is now for everyone out here, y'all. I don't know if I strip for you guys. How we feeling out here? I think we need to turn it up a little bit. How about you? talking about. Feel free to stand up if you want to. You don't have to, but you can, baby. Come on. Yeah, that's what I like to see now. Come on. Raisin on my name, blame my name on my reason, blame my lack of knowing better on public education, blame smoke on the fire, blame fire on the smoke, the fight on a bouncer that couldn't take a joke, but it ain't my fault. Get your hands up, I got my hands up, I need an alibi, find me a witness who can testify. It made a mistake, you got the wrong guy. I'm only guilty of a damn good time. No, it ain't my fault. It ain't my fault. Let me hear you. It ain't my fault. Come on.
Opry Live is brought to you by Balsam Hill, beautifully realistic Christmas trees and decor, and by proud partner of the Grand Ole Opry, Humana. It's not just healthcare, it's human care.
Well, hey, live streamers, it's Natalie Stovall. Thank y'all so much for hanging out with us tonight on this amazing Grand Ole Opry Live. Y'all, this has been such an amazing compilation of performances that, as you see, you had to see. We couldn't just have these hidden away. You had to see them. Now, one of our amazing sponsors that we have here at the Opry is helping us bring this show to you tonight is Blue Emu. Now, Blue Emu is the number one American emu oil formula. Blue Emu is for temporary relief of aches and pains, and y'all, that is something that all of us musicians, we need a lot of relief from those temporary aches and pains from carrying the instruments, playing the instruments, getting to and from the gigs. There's a lot of gear carrying that happens. So Blue Emu can provide that relief from strains, bruises, arthritis, and sprains. It works really fast, and it's fragrance-free. So thank you to Blue Emu for helping us bring you guys this Opry Live and for letting us live our lives with a little less pain. That's all very important. Man, that Brothers Osborne performance just now, If It Ain't My Fault, how great was that? I love watching John play guitar. He gets so into the solos. I never want the solos to end. Once he gets going, he really knows how to milk and build a solo, kind of take it down really small and sparse at first, and then build it up to this point where you can just feel the energy of the room surrounding the instruments. It's so cool. Now, these guys, they grew up with music in the house. I gotta tell you, we gotta start with their names, because John's full name is John Thomas Osborne, and TJ's full name is Thomas John Osborne. Their dad's name is John Thomas Osborne, although most people call him Big John. Big John had a band in their hometown of Maryland called Deuce and a Quarter, and John and TJ, they took to music pretty early on, and they really wanted to play in the band, and their dad was like, listen, boys, if you want to play in the band, you can, but you got to learn all 4 hours of music. So the boys learned 4 hours of music, and then they were able to join the band and really get their education as musicians. Now, these guys both wanted to pursue solo careers. They moved to Nashville, each of them with dreams of solo careers, but they'd save money by playing with each other in each other's bands, and then hence Brothers Osborne was born. Thank goodness for that. I sure do love their music, and we're going to get back to it right now. We are back. Thanks to the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, Brothers Osborne and Brad Paisley. You guys all make country music the place we want to live. All right, before we head out the door, one last time, here again is Brad Paisley. Good night, y'all.
I've got some big news. The bank finally came through. I'm holding the keys to a brand new Chevrolet. You've been outside, sure is a nice night. How about a little test drive down by the lake? There's a place I know about, and the dirt road runs out. We can try out the four-wheel drive. Come on now, what do you say? I can hardly wait. Come on! Hey, it's a good night. We out there soaking up the moonlight. Stay got a little piece of shoreline. I've got the perfect place in mind. It's in the middle of nowhere. One way to get there. Gotta get a little mud on the tires. How you doing tonight, Grand? On a duck blind, catfish on a trot line, sunset's about nine this time of year. We can throw a blanket down, crickets singing in the background, and more stars than we can count on a night this clear. Tell you what we need to do is grab a sleeping bag or two, build us a little campfire. Then with a little luck, we might just get stuck. Let's get a little mud on the tires. It's a good night. Be out there soaking up the moonlight. Stake out a little piece of shoreline. I've got the perfect place. Get stuck.